My name is Wenbo. This is a joint work with my teammates Alex Wadir. Say hi to everyone. Yeah, and another teammate is in Silicon Valley right now, and Dr. Xin Yuqing and Jimmy Su. We are from the JD.com security research lab. So today, maybe I'm going to talk something different. It's not about attack defense sort of things. So the title you can see here is about explanation. So we call this an alternative path to secure deep learning system. So first, sad news. All learning systems are exploitable, right? So why I draw this conclusion? So just first is because people are doing this. They keep attacking things. I remember one guy, he's a PhD in UC Berkeley. So he keep building a lot of, keep breaking a lot of learning systems. This is not from me, it's from Goodfellow. We all know him, right? So he's from Google. So he said this pipeline for different fielding. First, we can see as a very beginning, that no effort on adversary attack, and then goes down, right here. Do not generate over the threat model. So seems that it's very sad, right? But our ultimate goal is building a secure and trustworthy deep learning system. So of course we can still try in doing the defense sort of things to continue making our classifier more robust. Or we can go another path is that we can do explanation. So what we are doing right now is that we want to interpret in the deep learning model. We want giving an output, we want to know why the model makes this decision. So imagine if we know the reason of the every decision the model makes, we can make our own judgment whether this model is trustable or not, right? Here is a roadmap of my talk. First, I'm going to talk about what is model explanation, and talk about some existing explanation technologies, and then it's our work at JD, demonstration some results, and then it's come to a short summary. So first, what is explanation or interpretation? This is a definition actually given by me. So. It's not a formal one, but you can at least get a sense. It's like giving an input sample, we want to identify a set of important features that make key contribution to the model decision. For image recognition, it could be a group of a pixel. For segment analysis, it could be some keywords. For binary function stuff, is anyone here know about binary or something? It's never mind, just a sequence of hex. So it could be important instruction, which is hex. Here is an example. So giving this review, you see this review is definitely a negative review, right? So for human, why we think it's negative? Because we see this keyword, this price. What does not worth the price? So these are the keyword. So if a deep learning or like other machine learning model classifies this as negative, what we want to do is that we want to find this keyword. Why they make these decisions, right? So giving another example is binary function star identification things. A little bit background about binary function is that it's just a sequence of hex. What we want to do is sequence of hex is sequence of functions. So what we want to do, we just want to identify which hex is actually the function star. So here, the left side here is the demonstration of the assembling code, but here we're actually using the binary. So the model output, this sentence or this instruction is the function sum, it's the entries of the function. So explanation is that, the model thinks this one is the function sum because these two instructions are very important, of the high importance score. So from the binary people perspective, they all think this explanation makes sense because this push EBP, move EBP, ESP, I think is a well-known product. It's like a golden rule in this field. If you saw this rule, this definitely be a function stat. So if we get this explanation, we can say, okay, the model recognizes the right thing. So we probably maybe can trust this model. Okay, so goes down, actually, explanation is, I think it's maybe even harder than defense, because we have so many challenges right here. I just list two of them. He said first, the model structure very complex. It's very a lot. And there are two kinds of existing techniques. One is white box, one is black box. By words of white box, that you just go inside model layer by layer, you see what's going, how the information property, like things like that. And the other is black box that we treat the model as one. We just query, we get output, we use the input output, we do some things, and we get explanation. For people who are doing like me, who are doing security, we think that white box not that good. Because of following reasons. First one is that model architecture keep variance. Give you a simple example is that we, if we do recurrent neural nets, we all know that there are different kind of neurons, like GRU or LSTM sort of things. So if we design like say one method for one type of the hidden layer, it maybe cannot be transferred to the other layer, the other type. So you need to design one for each, which is time consuming. The second is that model architecture are not available in many security applications. Say, where is Toto? It's the online malware detection tools. We can only query it, we cannot get the architecture. The third reason is that some other issues that if you train the model to the segregated area, so the gradient maybe come to zero, so you can get nothing if you use gradient-based white box explanation method. So we switch to black box. So what is black box? Here is an example. So if we giving an input image, here is the orange. This I have say is like a deep neural network. Okay, the model will tell you this is the orange. And what we can do is that we use another function called CG. It's another type of model. And we use this model approximate to the F. Then when the image comes out again, the model will tell you, okay, so which part is important. So these are the important features. This is a bunch of, it just highlights the object here, it's only here, so this is so-called the explanation. So idea is pretty simple, is that we just do an approximation. So here is a bit of technique, so how we generate a explanation is that we first approximate the model with another transparency model, and then we inspect the like if you're using say linear regressions kind of things, you can inspect the regression coefficients, and then you can rank it and get the important features. Here's another example. It's he right here. So if this f of so this f is the nonlinear function of the neural network. So what we want to do is we want to get explanation for this image right here. So we want to approximate the local distance boundary of this F. So we use a linear. So we say we use a linear regression G of X, and then we get this parameter. It's called regression coefficients right here. And we rank them. We find the top three. So this indicates the most important parts. Okay. So, but we all know that deep neural network is highly nonlinear. The distance boundary is so complicated, so you cannot just approximate with a linear function. It will run into some problem. Here's the example. If you just approximate this function with a linear one, you can say it's not a very good approximation, and the explanation, of course, is not so good. So what we want to do is we try to do something different. We want to get a very precise, high precise approximation. So what we're seeking is we go to the statistical side. We found some mixture model, which is actually pretty good. This one called Dirichlet process mixture regression model is a mixture of linear regression. So I will not go that far detail. So is that the reason we select this model is that we want some high precision approximation. If we get a very accurate approximation, we can get better, very good explanation. So what we did to this model is that we add different regularization terms. So for different network structure, we add different regularization terms. So for MLP and CNN, we just use ElasticNet, which can give the approximation model, the model G, the ability to deal with high dimensional and highly quality data. For image, is that if you use doing some ImageNet or something else, is that hundreds times hundreds dimension. But we also doing something for the recognize, they said input the sequential data, basically deal with used in the NLP field. So we add a regression called fields lasso to deal with this kind of network. So this fields lasso can give us the ability to deal with the dependency within the input sequence. Say if there is a word, so example is I am Wombo. So the I and I am, they have some, and the third one, third word Wombo, they have certain kind of correlations. Correlations or dependence. So this fields also can give us ability to deal with this kind of dependence. So what we do is that to generating and to deriving an explanation, first we feed the mixture regression model. We feed the model with the input of the deep learning model and output of deep learning model. So we treat the model as variable to keep querying, get our own dataset and feed the model, feed our regression model with the dataset we crafted. After that, we leverage MCMC to do this. It's too much detail, just technical details, so I just skip. And then we found the best mixture components that the data lies in. If you see here, this is a model with maybe 5 components, and this one is actually where the data lies in. So I just pull this component out and get the regression coefficients of this component as our random find the important pixels or the as our explanation. See here the explanation way much better, because if you can see here we got the better approximation. Okay, so that's pretty much our model overview, right here, this size. But there are actually a lot of math, a lot of some technical detail which I just skipped, but we got paper, so you can maybe, if you're interested, you can refer later. So then I just show some results. Here is our explanation of single images. This come from 3 different datasets. One, first one is MIS, second one is fashion MIS, third one is well-known ImageNet. So you can see our method can always highlight the object. This is interesting. So this is a cat and the tiger. First, we want to explain why this is tiger. Second, we want to explain why this is a cat. So see, our method can always get to the right object. And also, going beyond explaining simple images, if we get the important feature of the images, we can actually do some good thing or bad things. One thing we can do is that we can synthesize some and also samples, right? So if we just nullify the important features inside those images, the image also looks like the original one. So here is also is one, this is two. But you put this image into the classifier, of course the deep learning classifier will fail to recognize them because you just remove the important features. The second thing is that we just pick up the most important features right here. The image no longer looks at what it should be, right? So here it is something like short or something else. You cannot recognize it, but the model can still classify it into the correct class. It's because we keep the most important feature. Also, another thing we did, I didn't show up here, is that we get this important image out and put it on this tool. So it's so messed up, but the model still classifies it as one because we keep the important feature of one. So this can be also another way of generating idle sample. You can use this model, use this image to retrain the model, make the model more robust. Here is another example, is a binary function start I mentioned before. It's originally trained by a recurrent network. So we got like 99.9 kind of accuracy. Also we explain this kind of, that neural network. So here is what we got. Here is the hex sequence. The color means the important score is like a heat map. We can see the most important sequence are here, right here. So if we disassemble this sequence, we can get the instruction right here. This instruction is a well-known pending at the end of the function. Let me explain this. If you have the first function with like 50 lines, the second function maybe the 70 lines. So there are 20 lines. So this one, like, usually the compiler will maybe insert some pending in there. So a lot of functions deal ending with this kind of pending. So of course the model, if the model see this kind of pending, they will say, okay, I see this, I saw this, maybe this one should be the function start. So this makes sense both on the model side, also on the binary side. So I show this result to someone, to some binary expert, they say, oh yeah, we usually recognize the function start ourselves, humanly, by recognizing this kind of tendency. This is just another example. This is also another well-known pending, and this is a well-known prologue. What this instruction did is just prepare the stack, so which is very common style of a function. Okay, so for explanation, what explanation can give us? Firstly, can if you see this result. If the binary expert who didn't believe in deep learning before, if you show the explanation result to them, they probably gonna change their view. I tried this before, so if they say okay, the model actually learned the right pattern, they probably tend to trust this model and use it. So this is the benefit the explanation bring to us, is that building trust of the model. Another benefit is that besides building trust, the model can pick up some new heuristics. This is also very interesting that some heuristics are not recognized by the expert. They only recognize like a small part of the whole heuristic set. And after we're doing the explanation, we extract the patterns, we can show the pattern to the expert and they know, okay, oh, this can be, they can verify them, right? They can verify the pattern. And then they find out, okay, this pattern could be the new heuristic, which enlarge their knowledge, which is also a good thing. So, okay, so here comes my summary. Is that firstly, as I mentioned before, defense is a long way to go, because reducing attack space is pretty hard. An alternative takeaway is explanation. So for security, we tend to black box explanation because the reason I mentioned before. And the benefit of explanation is that first we can, of course, explain in single instance. Also, we can scrutinize the model weakness, which I showed before, we can generate some adversarial sample. The other two is that we can build trust of model, get new knowledge, maybe generate some data to retrain model and make the model more robust and more accurate. Due to time, I just stop here. That's pretty much I want to talk today. So if you are interested in our work, you can just go to my personal homepage. We got two or three papers related to these topics. And we are also open for collaborations. Okay, thanks. Any questions? So is there any questions or just leave?
Yeah. Like you were looking at matching the cats on the picture. Are you trying to match any cats or specific cats?
Doesn't matter actually. So it's, I would say any cats.
You can pick up differences.
Yeah. As long as we generate enough training data to train our approximation model, we can do that.
Okay.
Okay. So thanks.